Hi children, welcome back again. Already we have discussed in the previous video about some of the rooms at our house. And next we have to start with the study room. That is, this is also one type of room in our house we use for one good purpose, that is studying. You might have seen your brothers or sisters will be there. They will be having a study, one separate room where the shelf and cupboard is made. One table will be there and one chair will be there. They will sit on that chair, and just opposite of how they are sitting, just opposite of that we will be having one light bulb, so we can get sufficient light to read during night also. And we will be having windows also for that room to get the sunlight inside. So that room is used for the studying purpose. Sometimes we need one special room or place to study ourselves, because we need to concentrate. So it will be possible for us to concentrate ourselves in that particular area. So that room is known as the study room, where we usually keep all types of books. And that study room may be used for more than two members also. If I have one sister, so another room also, another table also can be kept there. So even I can also go and sit, and I can also use one my particular cupboard. So I can also use that room for studying. Another, my brother is there. He can also use that room for studying. But we should not disturb there. We should not talk to each other. We should keep quiet, maintain silence, and we should study there. So this is how the study room is used. Then we have the garden. This is also part of our house. Usually there will be a place just around our house, whichever we have constructed, or that may be the rent also. So in that, usually we have the habit of growing some grass, making garden, and planting some flowers, different types of flowers, especially like rose, hibiscus, like this. And even in the garden we can have the some types of plants or trees, like fruits, custard apple, guava, lemon, mango, coconut also, tree also we can plant. So these are the some common trees where we are going to grow in our garden. So that can look very beautiful, and even we can spend some of the time in our garden also, in the evening or in the morning. So we can spend the time in the garden. So the garden is also one of the part of our house. Next, if we have the car, we have the bike, we have some other vehicle, cruiser, tempo, or the jeep, you can say. So if we have like that vehicles, usually whoever will be having those vehicles, they make someone shed like, or they make one separate room for that one to keep that vehicle. That may be car, that may be jeep, that may be cruiser, that may be bolero, that may be bike, many bikes, scooters. So particularly those vehicles, we bring them to that room, and we will keep them, and we are going to lock the gate of that room, because we want to keep them safe than the sunlight, than the rain, and than the from the thief. Night time there will be possibility of stealing those all vehicles, so we will keep them in a safe manner. This garage is used for that purpose. And we have learned now, till now, what are the different types of the rooms. Next we have, how do we can take care of our house? Is it taking care of our house is also there? Is it necessary? Yeah, it is necessary. Say, simply we have our house. We have built it from, we means our parents have built it from 20 years. Then we, from 10, 20 years, we never mopped that, we never dusted that house, we never clean painted that house, we never cleaned that house. Then how do it is going to look? Isn't it? Then taking care of our house is also most important. Then the first one is, we must dust the house. And we must mop the rooms, floor. Maybe once in a one day, or twice in a day. Usually once in a per day, a mopping is compulsory, because there will be lot of dust, lot of outside things are going to come along with our feet. Then we must mop those all the rooms, floors of the all the rooms, and we must dust the rooms, the whole house, at least twice in a year. That is, at least after 3 months, next after 3 months, like this, twice in a year. Twice in a year, we must dust. Then we should keep the things in correct manner. Where TV should be, where bed should be, where sofa set should be. And if I take sofa set and go and keep in a garage, what is the use? And if I take the car and I'm keeping in the hall, living room, what is the use? Isn't it? If I take some other things and going and keeping in the bed, all the beds I'll take, I'll pack and I'll keep in the kitchen. Then what will happen? Should not do like this. We should think which things can be kept in a particular area. In bedroom, what things can be kept? In kitchen, what things can be kept? TV, where should be kept? My studying all materials, where should be kept? These all I should think, and each of us, all the members of the house, whatever we take from the house, whatever the things we are taking, no, after using that one, we should go and keep that one in a its own place. Okay, that is keeping things in a correct place. Then we should allow sunlight and air in a home, lot of, because of this only to get the air. We have doors, we have windows, we have the ventilators, and we should build a house after building. Of course, everyone after while building, they will keep the windows, they will keep the door. What happens if I am closing this door for the 6 months? I have never opened this door. I have never opened any windows of this room. What happens? Every day, at least for 5 to 6 hours or 1 to 2 hours, I should open this door, I should open the windows, so that the fresh air will enter the house. And whatever the impure air is there inside the house, room, it should go out. So we will be very fresh by doing like this. So like this, by doing like this, allowing the sunlight, by opening window and doors, we can allow the sunlight and the air inside the house, that is inside the room. So this is how, following the simple steps, we can take care of our house. This is what the third lesson of rooms in house. Children, here ends your lesson. And after ending this, please solve the exercise part. Yeah, I can't read all the questions. Whatever there in the exercise part, please solve that one. And if you want to post those all that one, I will give you the my WhatsApp number. So after solving, you can take a pics of them and you can send to my WhatsApp number. I hope you have enjoyed these all the things whatever we have discussed, and even you have enjoyed whatever the lessons are taught now already, and you all are doing homework correctly. And then keep doing like this. Enjoy the videos, and let us meet in the next video. Till then, take care of yourself and bye-bye.